my name is Gabriela Barahona. Welcome to English class in 5 minutes. And today we are going to talk about phrasal verbs. But first, we have to know what is a phrasal verb. A phrasal verb, it's a verb that consists of two or three words. These words usually are verb plus an adverb or pronoun. Here we have an example. The first example is look into, which means research. Another example is to find out, which means to discover. We have two kind of phrasal verb. The first is transitive and the second one is intransitive. All the verbs are intransitive and transitive phrasal verb. So how we can recognize them and what is the difference between them? Well, a transitive phrasal verb takes an object. Here we have an example. Hang up your jacket. Hang up is the phrasal verb. Jacket is the object. Another example is take away the dish. Take away is the phrasal verb. Dishes is the object. In the case of transitive phrasal verb, we can put the object between the verb and adverb or preposition, or we can put it after words. And that if we separate the name of the person or things, we can put it in the middle of the sentence or after it. Here we have some examples. Take off your jacket. Take off is the phrasal verb. Jacket is the object. In this case, object goes before the phrasal, after the phrasal verb. Now, we can say, take your jacket off. Now, in this case, jacket is the object and goes in the middle of the sentence. But if there are pronoun, we'll put always the pronoun in the middle of the sentence. For example, I'll pick it up to 7 a.m. So, him is the pronoun. Another example, I didn't understand the word, so I look it up in the dictionary. It is the pronoun, and we cannot move, because if we move it, the meaning of the sentence will change. Now, let's move on to intransitive phrasal verb. Intransitive phrasal verb are easy to use because there's no object and intransitive phrasal verb are always inseparable. That means that they always will go together. Here we have some examples to better understand. The first example is, the plane took off and landed on time. Took off is the intransitive phrasal verb, which means left the room. Another example is, you're doing really well, so carry on like this. As we can see, we don't have an object here, and carry on, which means continue. And the last example is, did you get the ticket? No, they sold out. Sold out, the intransitive phrasal verb, which means sell all those available. Now, let's move on to some exercise. The first exercise is, my colleague and I get on really well. But how we can know if this sentence is transitive or intransitive? Well, as we can see, we don't have an object here, so we can say that this sentence is an intransitive phrasal verb. And the phrasal verb is get on. Another exercise. Pick out the chair you like best. Here we have an object which is chair. And that means that this sentence is transitive phrasal verb. And the phrasal verb is pick out. Well, I hope you like it. Thank you for your attention, and remember, transitive phrasal verb always takes an object, and intransitive phrasal verb there's no object. Thank you for your attention.